Hey YouTube, the month of October is over, so it is time for my October favorites, and I'm just gonna hop right in there. So first off, I'm gonna give you something that I'm wearing right now, because you're gonna see it, and you're gonna wonder, and I'm just gonna tell you straight out. This is Essie's Ladylike, and this polish is gorgeous. It is the perfect dusty grayish pink color. I've had this on for about a week, and no chips, no nothing. It stayed on, it stayed put, it's great. I have two lipsticks for you that are my favorites. First off, I have something that's kind of an interesting color, and you may not like it, but this is Peach Stock by MAC, and I really, really like this color. I really like the nude lip, and when I put this on, I don't know, it kind of just makes me feel like I'm in the 60s. It feels like a very 60s nude lip, and I really, really love the color. I think it was in the MAC Me Over collection, but it's permanent in the pro stores, so check out Peach Stock if you're looking for a nude lip, and this is what it looks like swatched. It's kind of, you know what it looks like to me? It looks like all the concealers and like touch-up sticks that I've bought that haven't matched my skin tone, because that's what they've always looked like on my skin. Too orange, too yellow, but I really like this on my lips. It's a great color. And the next lipstick that I have been loving this month is what is on my lips right now, and this is Dubonnet, and this was just in my recent haul video from the CO, but this is just a really gorgeous color, and it's the perfect mix between deep vampy colors and bold bright red, so been loving that. Obviously I'm wearing it. So blushes that I have been loving this month, there's two. One is, once again, Notable. I've shown this three times now in videos, but it's such an amazing color. I love it. What more can I say? I've pretty much worn this every single day, and any day that I wasn't wearing this color, I was wearing NARS Luster. And I got this in a Makeup Alley swap, and I have been loving it and wearing it ever since. It's a really beautiful kind of peachy, orangey, apricot kind of shimmery color, and it's right there on this finger with Notable on the other, and I just have been really loving it. I can use it as a blush, or I could just use it as a highlight, so it's pretty versatile, and it's just absolutely gorgeous. I have also been loving the MAC 217 brush, and I only got this 2 months ago, and I don't know how I survived without it. This is such an amazing brush, such an amazing brush. It's dirty, obviously, because I just used it today and I didn't have time to wash it, but I want to get many of these because I don't want to have to worry about washing it all the time, because I can use it for applying shadow all over the lid. I can just use it in my crease. I can use it for applying highlight, inner corner, on my brow bone. It's such an amazing versatile brush, and so you should definitely check it out if you're looking for an eyeshadow brush and you don't want to spend a lot of money on getting all different kinds of ones, because this one can really do a lot. It's great for blending. It's just a really amazing brush. I can't recommend it enough. And everyone knows that, really. If you're watching my videos, you probably already have one, and so you're like, duh, hello, get with the times. I have also been loving my Makeup Forever HD High Definition Concealer, and I use the shade 110. No, I use the shade 110 in the foundation, but for some reason it's called 310 in the concealer. Okay, so I use 310, and this is really great. It has kind of an interesting applicator. It's plastic, and you will twist the bottom, and then there's a little hole, and it comes out of the hole. There, you can see the hole there. So it'll come out of there, so you kind of just like drag it and wipe it, but it's a little bit more sanitary, I think, than those gross brushes, because I never really liked those gross brushes that much. Another thing that I have been totally digging this month is my Smashbox iBeam double-ended brightener. And so this has, one side is kind of large, and this is supposed to be your highlight that you can use like on your brow bone, and then there is a side that has a little bit of a smaller part, and this is for your inner rim, they say, so your waterline on your bottom lash. And I have been using this almost every day just to brighten up my eyes and really make them feel big, and I think it's just a great way to wear your makeup and have it be subtle but really look fresh and alive, and so I have been totally in love with this. Another product that I have been loving for the value of it, and because it's been really great, is this e.l.f. Healthy Glow Bronzing Powder. So I got this, probably cost me $2 or $3, and it has been an amazing highlighter. I've been really digging it, really loving it. It reminds me of my Mineralize Skin Finish Soft and Gentle, except maybe a little bit more orangey and a little bit less peachy. But this has been great. I've just been using this as my highlight, and I really love it. And I have also been loving MAC's Prance Mega Metal Eyeshadow. And this has been my go-to eyeshadow for days when I really don't want to look like I'm wearing that much makeup, but I do want to have a little something on. So pairing this Prance Mega Metal Eyeshadow with my Smashbox Double Ended Brightener has just given me such like a fresh, awake look for the days when I'm really not fresh and I'm really not awake because I have to wake up early and drive forever to school. Okay, so I also have some skincare products too. And the first one that I have been loving is this Boots Botanics Face Rose Water Toner. And I have been using this on the days where I really do a lot to my skin and I need something that's gentle to kind of not dry out my skin anymore, because some toners can be kind of harsh. And I do have an Alba one that when I do it, I kind of feel a sting and a burn in my face. And so I don't want to feel that on days when I've already done so much to my skin. And this smells amazing. I would wear this as a perfume. It smells so good. So this toner is just the perfect gentle, and it's 100% certified organic. So that's nice. I really, really, really want to try to cut down on the amount of chemicals that I'm just throwing on myself. So anything that I can do to lower that works for me. And another product I have been loving are these Yes to Tomatoes Deep Cleansing Facial Pads, and they have salicylic acid in them. So I use these on days when I'm kind of lazy, I do a crappy job washing my face because I just use wipes or something, and it's late, and I just use this to try to help curb any hormonal breakouts I have. I really only have them on my chin, and they really seem to be just hormonal, but I still want to do everything I can to avoid them because they suck. I know I probably should just do a really good job washing my skin every night, but sometimes it's 1 a.m, I have 6 hours to sleep, and I just want to go to bed. And they also smell really nice. If you have Smell-O-Vision on your computer, go ahead and just take a whiff of that right there. I know, so good, right? But these smell really good for being kind of like an acne treatment pad, so they've come a long way from the Stridex I used to use when I was 15. My last product to share is an Alba oil-free moisturizer, and this is the aloe and green tea version. And I have been loving this, and I know what you're thinking. Hey, you told me that the Avalon Organics facial cream was the best thing in the world last month. What are you doing talking about this? Well, some people don't want facial creams. Sometimes moisturizer is the way to go. And I like this for mixing with my foundation sometimes when I don't want super heavy coverage and I don't want to feel like I'm like caked on with foundation. So some days I even mix this with my tinted moisturizer just to make it super, super light. But I really, really love this. It smells amazing. And so if you're looking for a moisturizer and you want something that's not too chemically, I recommend this Alba oil-free moisturizer. So that is the last of my products. I hope you enjoyed my video. Maybe some of these products are your favorites, or you've tried them, or maybe you absolutely hate them. But let's get a dialogue going. Leave me a comment, or if you made a favorites video, leave it as a video response. Let's chat it up, y'all. Okay, I hope you have a good day and a good Halloween and you're not stressing too much over your costume. I still don't know what I'm gonna be. But that's how it always is. So, bye guys. Have a good day.